In this video, we will cover the normalization and PCA step when analyzing Visium spatial transcriptomics data in Chipster. This step consists of two methods, normalization with SC transform and dimensionality reduction with principal component analysis. In this step, the gene expression values are first normalized and highly variable genes are detected. Then, PCA is performed using the highly variable genes. This tool finally outputs a sera object after PCA. This tool also outputs PCA plots that can be used to select the number of PCs used in the next step. The goal of this normalization step is to remove the technical variation but preserve the biological differences. More specifically, we are trying to remove the correlation between the sequencing depth and gene expression level of a spot such that the variance of a normalized gene across spots primarily reflects the biological differences independent of sequencing depth. As you can see from the figure, SC transform may do a better job at this, especially with the highly expressing genes. Remember that SC transform also detects highly variable genes and returns the normalized gene expression values for these genes. So after SC transform, only the detected highly variable genes are returned, as we are only interested in the genes with the most information. This reduces the dimensionality from the number of the original genes to the number of the returned variable genes. However, there are still correlations between the highly variable genes, and we would only like to preserve the highest variation in the data for the clustering step. This is the goal of the PCA step. In PCA, we reduce the dimensionality by transforming the feature space with the highly variable genes into a lower dimensional feature space, where the first principal component captures the most variation in the data, and the second PC the second most, and so on. In this new PCA space, the PCs can be considered as metagenes that are linear combinations of the highly variable genes. Now let's take a look at how to use this tool in Chipster. If we only have one sample, we can use this normalization and PCA tool for this step. If we have more than one sample, we can use this combined multiple samples normalization and PCA tool for this step, as this also includes a method to combine the samples. We will go through this in more detail later, but for now, we will only look at the analysis with one sample. We can select the sera object after the filtering step and select the values for the parameters. We can choose the number of variable genes to return in SC transform, and we can choose the number of computed PC components. We can also choose whether we want to print the PC loadings in a text file. And we can run the tool. This tool outputs a sera object, PCA plots, and optionally also the PC loadings text file. The PCA plots can be helpful in selecting the number of PCs for the next clustering step.